Hey guys, just like I promised, in this video you'll be able to see germane, even though it's colorless and you cannot feel its awful smell through your display. We'll get germane by the reaction of lithium aluminum hydride in dry diethyl ether and germanium tetrachloride. Diethyl ether must be absolutely dry, otherwise nothing will happen, because lithium aluminum hydride will react with what water an undrained ether contains. Adding a dry ether to lithium aluminum hydride will not result in any gas emission whatsoever. As a comparison, I'll add some ordinary non-drained diethyl ether to lithium aluminum hydride, and you can see gas bubbles appear right away. That means the reaction between the hydride and water occurs, resulting in the emission of hydrogen. One more important condition for getting germane is having either a dry inner gas or a dry air flow in our aggregate. Otherwise, emitting germane will react with air moisture, forming germanium dioxide. I will feed argon through a silicon hose, and this tube is where a mixture of germane and argon will emerge from. The only thing we have left to do is to mix the components. I will add germanium tetrachloride in lithium aluminum hydride ether solution using a dropping funnel. I will dip the tube with emitting germane into a silver nitrate solution. I will then feed a moderate argon flow, and then we can start to add germanium tetrachloride to the solution of lithium aluminum hydride in diethyl ether. The reaction with silver nitrate is a germane qualitative reaction, as it results in the formation of a dark non-water soluble chemical, that is silver germanide. In air, germane burns in orange-red color. However, its combustion is interrupted due to the presence of argon in the mixture with germane and due to the lack of oxygen. This white smoke that forms during the combustion represents germanium dioxide. I will feed the mixture of germane and argon through one end of the attached glass tube, and I will dip the other end into potassium hydroxide to absorb germane. That will not decompose when heated. And now it's time for the most interesting reaction, that is the germane decomposition reaction in a glass tube with the formation of germanium mirror. When the temperature in the tube will start to exceed 300 degrees Celsius, we'll be able to see germanium mirror forming. Note that the amount of germanium that settles down on the tube walls is the greatest in the areas where a gas torch contacted the tube. And this is how we got a glass tube covered with germanium on our inside. A similar germane decomposition reaction is used in electronics manufacturing to get extra pure germanium. Thanks for watching, guys, and special thanks to my patrons. I'm truly grateful to you for your support. See you in the next video.